Good morning, guys. It's not really morning, but because we slept in. It's exactly 12 noon right now. And it's Tuesday the 29th. Happy Tuesday. What?
I didn't get that off yet.
And so, we slept in because we felt like it, because it's my day off today, so that's why. And
it's supposed to be going to 33 today.
Yeah, it already feels very warm in the house already. Because it's going to be, it's already at, 26 right now. It's already at 26 right now, guys. It's glaring here. And it's supposed to go to a high of 32 and 33 tomorrow. And so, I already turned on the fan. And so, this fan here actually works very good. And there's a low setting and a high setting. And the high setting would be almost like an air conditioner, but the low setting is enough. But, yeah. So today I want to make some jam. It's a new recipe I'm going to be testing out. I'll just show you a little bit. And so if it really works out, I might make an actual video on it. So, let's get going on with the day, guys, since we slept in already today. So, since it's so flipping warm in here, I decided to make some iced coffee. But, you know, I don't know, but, like, might be the psychology or something behind it, but I do give kudos to Starbucks, because even the ones that I make at home don't taste as nice as the one it doesn't taste as nice as the one Starbucks makes. Oh, I got that kink in my throat. Oh, that's annoying. I just haven't been able to get rid of that weird itch or tickle in my throat. It's really annoying. But yep, iced coffee's being made, guys. Yum, yum. Iced coffee done. And so, it's this Tassimo iced coffee stuff. And so, I got breakfast or brunch here, whatever you like to call it. And I'm experimenting with this chia seed cereal. Like, I don't know if it's because I add too much liquid or something to it. It's not, like, gelling up like some other YouTube videos I'm seeing. Like, it's supposed to be more solid than this, but maybe I added too much liquid. Okay, so, got some ham sandwich with the bread I made of 1 or 2 days ago, which is nice. So, it's a nice sunny day out, guys. Ooh, brightness. So, yep. We're gonna be headed off soon out there later, guys. It's just getting really slow. I'm just lazying around the house here. So, it's just past 1 o'clock. And so, I got the jars and stuff here in a water bath. It's a boiling hot water bath to sterilize the jars. Like, I know you should need to get a proper canning pot or whatever, but we don't have the money to get all those fancy gadgets and gizmos. Plus, I'm not a regular canner. I just do it for fun here and there. So, yeah. And so this recipe, because like a few times I tried to do it with the pectin, and sometimes like I've read here and there, some fruits have more pectin than others, and so sometimes the pectin might mess up your fruit. So I was looking up on Pinterest for a jam ideas. And so I found this thing. It's the chia seed jam. So I was like, oh, that's interesting. And so all you need is to blitz up your fruit. Lemon juice. Need some lemon juice. Some honey. And like a few tablespoons of this chia stuff, depending on how thick you like it, and your fruit. And so you need to heat it up a bit in the pot too. So yeah, And so, how did I miss out on this trend, guys? So, that's what we're doing today, and I'll show you the results. And, I asked Matthew if he wanted chunky or smooth jam, and he asked for smooth, so that's why I took this big thing out. Okay, and, because for me, the reason that I like to make jam at home is because I'm Asian, and I, like, still sometimes I don't like things too sweet, and a lot of those commercial jams out there is too sweet for me, so I choose to use honey as a sweetener. So yeah, like that's the thing, you make stuff at home, you get to choose how sweet or whatever, the way you like your stuff. And my very first YouTube video years ago was a jam making video too. So this is a new and improved demo per se. So, and this is the chia seed that I've got here. So yeah, so make sure it's just the plain stuff, the wild chia. None of the other stuff added to it, because some other blends, they have like cranberries or whatever added to it. No, just use the plain stuff and you should be good to go. And so I'll just test this recipe out and I'll show you the finished results, guys. So got this all nicely smoothed out. It looks like some type of a pumpkin puree or something, but I also added some mango. So it's peach and mango. And I added in some lemon juice already, so I just set it on high, on the medium, high heat. So now I'm just gonna add some honey to it. Maybe about a quarter cup, or a big dollop of it. Just stir everything in. If you guys had a smell-o-vision earlier, you guys would be worried. The blender was getting freaking smoking hot. It's like this cheap blender that we bought a while ago, but it's a cheap blender. But oh, Matthew's home again. Matthew, help me hold this. Hold this. It's recording. As the thingamajiggy is heating up. So depending on how much thick you like your jam, I like my jam thick. I like my jam to be thick, so I'm adding in about 2 or 3 tablespoons of this the chia seeds in here. Yeah, we'll go with 4. Okay. So it just depends on how thick you like your jam, because as this chia seed takes on the liquid, it will swell up and make a gel. And I've seen the pictures on Pinterest, they all look very lovely, so that's why we're trying it out this recipe today. Look at this, it looks like some pumpkin puree and black sesame seeds, but I swear to you guys, it is peach and mango. I added mango to this, Matthew. Matthew doesn't know I added mango to it. So right now you have to cook it until it gets thicker, which would be about like 10-12 minutes, okay? So we'll be back soon. But the jam jars are all setting here now. So we just have to wait a little bit for them to get ready before we open them. Yep, so I think I added a little bit wee much lemon juice, but it's okay. At least it's not as sweet as the other stuff, but it's good. So the lemon juice would actually help it to preserve more and to keep the color more. So yep, now we're off to whatever Matthew needs to do for the day. Now Matthew has to do a few things today, right, Matthew? And we're off. And so we have to go all the way into the Goondocks, to the opposite end of the city, to Matthew's the office for where Matthew's job.
Excuse me.
To where Matthew's job was last weekend, and he got a drop off for some paperwork, and to so that he can get paid for the next round. And then he's gonna go see if there's any more openings for the coming weekend, right, Matthew?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're off and we have a few places to hit and we'd be back home again soon, guys. It's a hot day out. How much is it out there now?
According to the car, 28. According to my weather station, 32. What does yours say?
Still it's 32, guys. 29 right now. This is a prettier part of the drive. Calgary downtown is over there. The Calgary Tower. Like, we're on the Deerfoot Trail here. Like, as we were driving, it's like, seriously, it's like those people, it's like, even in those trucks and stuff, like, people were like, eating, talking on the phone. Oh my God, it's like, Deerfoot Trail is one of the worst roads in Calgary for car accidents. Like, doesn't people know that? It's like, really? It's like the equivalent of the interstates for the U.S.
Oh,
it's one of the...
For years and
it's one of the busiest roads in Calgary. It like connects what? It connects all the way to Edmonton. You can come. You can use this road all the way to go up to Edmonton. And so, really disturbed drivers out there. It's really crazy. Like, where's the policeman when you need these people? When you need to take these people off the road? Okay.
Happy customers, lowest pricing. Interesting.
All right, we're turning off to Glenmore. This is what I mean by in the middle of the Goondocks nowhere. It's all these weird
businesses and warehouses.
All these weird oddball businesses and offices.
Well, this is the head office for the
and
the
so
world.
It's like if you ever like. You don't really need to come down here every day, not like for shopping purposes, but it's
no,
like,
not down here.
It's like, if it's some particular, like, if you need some like particular trade or service or something, some really oddball stuff, then you come down here. It's really, really weird. Really, really far and weird places out here. Like, by the layout of this place, I guess you guys will understand what I mean. It's like, it's all these boring-looking office buildings. They don't even try to make it look pretty. Okay, so Matthew picked up one shift, right?
I picked up one more shift this week to try it out.
To try out. It's something a bit different, but yeah.
If it works out, then I've got another three more shifts that I can pick up.
Okay, guys, so we're off to Walmart and to get gas. We're almost empty, guys. Look. We're off to Walmart. Okay, guys. Really nice day out, though, again. But I think I said that already.
Yeah, she's actually saved and booked those shifts for me.
Oh.
I just have to let her know if it's for sure or should she find somebody else.
Yeah. Okay.
But right now, I'm already guaranteed them if I want.
Well, we are here again. Army and Navy again. Let's see what damage we do in here again today, guys. I didn't know Dr. Pepper came in Twizzlers. Gotta get that for sure. What?
Do you want a strawberry one as well?
Yum, 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 yum.
Yum, yum?
Yum, yum. Oh my gosh, this is a dangerous place.
Yes, it's a dangerous place.
Anybody want a big thing of red peppers here? I never knew there was such a thing as canned asparagus. Is there such a thing as canned asparagus? They have canned asparagus.
No, I gotta go to Costco.
Ooh, this is dangerous place here, guys. I know they sell that at regular grocery stores. Yeah.
Szechuan.
Ooh, I haven't seen a thing of tartar sauce. Mushroom bouillon, what? Mushroom. Hey, they got different flavors of onion bouillon things. What? Is this like a drink or something? We did some damage in here, Army and Navy. And so, for your information, if you're skinny people out there, as if it's not too hard for you, because they do have a very good size range in pants. They even have 30, 31, 32, like as in the waistline for men, that is. But a lot of stores these days, they don't carry the odd number waistlines anymore. Wait, right, Matthew?
No, you don't find.
Yeah, they even have a size 31 waistline. So if you're that skinny, if you have problems with that, you can come here to buy pants, okay? If that's a problem for you guys. And so, we bought those yummy croissants again.
That's supposed to be a stop sign.
And so, we are now headed to Walmart to get a few odds and ends at Walmart. And what other stuff is left to do, Matthew, besides Walmart?
That's it.
And we have to get gas too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oop, almost had an accident.
Hello, world. We're now in Deerfoot Trail rush hour. We do have rush hour in Calgary, you know.
Yeah, let's stay going this way.
You guys can see the rush hour better at this angle. The cars are all the way around to the corner. There's the rush hour spirit.
This is just the beginning of the rush hour.
Showing you the rush hour spirit of Deerfoot Trail. All right, guys.
This is gonna go on for another hour or so.
So how fast is this motorcycle guy gonna get him the vroom vroom?
Time to... See, it's only saying that we should be there.
Oh, they got these timer things here.
6 minutes. I don't know. We're not that
They
far.
Show us these time markers, like the American style highways. So that hopefully people don't rush. Yeah, sure.
No, so you can time yourself and go, oh my God, should I stay on here or should I get off and take a different route?
All right.
In half an hour.
Oh, I haven't bought it for a while. This bottle lasts a long time. They got a usual stuff I like. A big honking bottle for less than $2. Matthew, give me that bottle. Show. This is the one that I've always bought. It's a European with all hair types. Ooh, I'm really tempted to buy this one, guys. Greek yogurt maker. Does anybody know if this stuff works? Please tell me, guys. Greek yogurt. I did one big mistake today, guys. I forgot to bring water out on a hot day. So we went to Mickey D's. I got my usual iced coffee, and Matthew got the what?
The Freestone peach smoothie.
I don't know if you guys can pick up the orange, but it's like so nice and orange color. It's actually not bad. It tastes like peach jello. It really does.
Peach jello.
Yeah, I had a zip of it. Okay, so we're headed to more shopping. Today would be a big damage day. Will you guys see me use this thing for chicken roaster? They apparently have one for turkey. Matthew, I don't know, is this even big enough?
Yeah.
This one's for a turkey. We are at some liquidation store. What are you getting?
Because I need that to clean out the thing in the front, in the vent.
Dryer lint.
Okay. Bacon tree.
Ooh, bacon tree. Ooh, that looks pretty. I like it.
Look down.
Ooh, I need to get me one of these. It's $5.
You've already got one.
No, that one is starting to scrape off. I need to replace one. Bacon tree, anyone? So this store turns out to be one of those quirky kitchen gadget stores. S'mores maker. Microwave graham crackers, marshmallows, and chocolate. Evenly at the same time. S'mores, anybody? Or... Ooh, silicone cupcake. lots of quirky stuff in here. What? Yeah? Oh, I've seen these before. Mini pie makers. As we don't have enough gadgets already.
Exactly.
Gizmos and gadgets. Oh guys, we did a big damage shopping today. We went to 3 or 4 shops today. And the time is just 5:30. And now, cause I'm planning to make a beef roast for dinner tonight, so it's gonna be another late dinner. And so, yep. We actually didn't hit the bakery today.
No,
at Wally Mart because it's too hot.
There's only
and
supposed to be a few stops, so we ended up stopping at 6 places.
And because it's too hot and the bakery stuff would melt in the car, so we didn't get any cakes there today. Sorry, Walmart. And so, yep, we're headed home now, and I don't know how long this video will be, but then I'll probably make a separate shopping haul video. But usually we don't shop this much, but because we really were running out of stuff since Matthew lost his job and we really haven't been shopping. So this is one of the bigger shopping that we did.
Shoot.
We forgot to get gas, so we are out here at Costco. We're at Costco now to get gas, and look at that, there's the lineup. Because the Costco is always a few cents lower than the market price, so. And they've got four lanes going on per side, and it's still a big lineup here, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we're getting gas. The time is now 6:15 now, so I think I'm gonna set the oven for dinner, for the roast. And then let's see how the jams are doing today. Ooh. They look like it vacuum sealed pretty good. Because this is not like a refrigerator jam recipe. Well, you could make it into a refrigerator jam or a freezer jam, but you just have to keep it in the fridge. But this looks like it's sealed up pretty nicely. Matthew, look. Matthew. Looks like it's sealed up nicely. So we could just store it in the pantry now. Eh?
Yeah.
It works. Okay. So, I got a haul to show you guys, so I'll do it in a separate video. Oh, I don't know what happened to this today's time, guys. It seemed very fast. It's 7 o'clock almost. And the roast isn't even in yet. And so, I decided to do some different seasonings here. I put on some barbecue sauce, and then I put on this burger seasoning and some seasoning salt. The seasoning salt here. I don't know why it seems to be my favorite combo lately. And I also added some sriracha powder that I got and some barbecue sauce over. So in this goes. And I'm gonna let this no cover for 10-15 minutes to crisp up the top and then put a cover on. And then in the meantime, I'm gonna work on this little project to label these jam jars. Okay guys, labels are all done. They look official now, don't they? Yeah, the seals turned out pretty nice. And this one is being annoying the whole day. Yeah. It's not making any popping noise.
Oh, yeah. They look like they're sealed good.
Okay, guys. Now it's waiting for dinner. This is what the Ocean Spray. That great thing that we bought today. The Soda Stream. It's really fizzy, isn't it, Matthew?
Holy fizzy.
Like sometimes, like the different Soda Streams, we make it the exact same way for every one of them. Some of the syrups are more fizzier than others, hey? Matthew? Mmm. Now this is gonna get me a purple tongue for sure. Oh, I got Matthew on gravy and potato duty today. And so, it's a really late dinner. Almost 9 o'clock. We really haven't eaten any real food since what we showed you what we had for breakfast today.
Breakfast, and my lunch, brunch, whatever you want to call it.
And my stomach is caving in. I'm so hungry right now. And so, I got Matthew on gravy duty because I can never make gravy. So I made some really nice gravy. Roast beef turned out lovely. And got the vegetables. So I'm really ready to tuck in now. So I hope you guys had a lovely Tuesday. And I'm already starting to edit the video a little bit, but I haven't uploaded it yet. So, yep, so I'll see you in tomorrow's vlog, and I'll see you guys. Thanks for watching.